I check out hundreds of productivity apps every single year, and one of the biggest questions I get asked is, Francesco, what productivity apps do you use? So today we're diving into all of those ones, and I'm gonna share what I use for email, what I use for task management, and what I use for note-taking, and many more. So if you're in the hunt for productivity tools or software for work, jump over to Tool Finder. We're growing it very fast, and it'll help you find the perfect one for you. So, productivity apps, obviously, something I cover a lot here on the channel. And I find this question so weird when people ask it. It's sort of like asking the ice cream man, what ice cream is your favorite? It's sort of, I don't know, not as valuable, I don't think. Like asking a taxi driver what his favorite car is. I don't know, maybe it's not the same context. But I find it strange when people ask me, but it's probably because I've checked out so many. I wanted to dive into the 5 that I use now. I mainly keep to these 5 pretty strictly. And I'll talk about how and what context I use them in daily. So for task management, I use Todoist. I've used Todoist for probably about 12 years collectively, with a 3-year stint with Sensama a few years back. But largely, Todoist I find is a reliable, easy to use experience for helping me to plan my tasks for the week ahead. Now, I don't really plan massively in advance, typically probably 2 weeks at maximum for all of my tasks, because every week I tend to have a session on Thursday that allows me to break down what I'm going to do for the next week, which then determines the landscape for that week ahead. And that's probably because I'm running a sort of typical, I don't know, not a typical startup, but a startup company with a co-founder. And of course, that shapes things every single week, new decisions, move that, meetings, etc. So I wouldn't say I plan much more than 2 weeks in advance. But the application I love, and one of the reasons I'm sort of sticking with it much more so recently, is because I actually am looking forward to the calendar mode, which I think will add that layer that I'm potentially missing in my day-to-day productivity. So in terms of my calendar application, I choose one called Rise Calendar. Now, this one is more recently been pushing towards being more of a project management application, so I'm fingers crossed that this one won't shut down. But Rise Calendar is a beautiful experience for helping you to plan your tasks and being able to see what's ahead in your calendar. Now, as I said, I'm looking forward to Todoist to get a calendar, and I actually don't use Calendar quite a lot because I don't have many meetings at all. I try to be asynchronous across my week, and I probably typically have only one meeting a week. So actually using a calendar app is pretty minimal. I only do it to check whether I have anything in my daily routine. So maybe if Todoist introduced a calendar with a Google Calendar ability, I might not even use a calendar application going forward. But I typically find that calendar apps are like moving phones. It's quite easy because you can just plug in with the calendar provider that you've got. Task management and note-taking applications are a bit more trickier, and that's why you should stay with them much longer. And that's why I've been with something like Todoist for like 11, 12 years collectively. Next up, my email application is Superhuman. And again, much easier to move across, but I was pretty much using Tempo for several years. But then Tempo shut down as an email application, and I was looking for one and think email should be one of my priorities because I was dealing with a lot of partnerships and brand deals at the time. And now I continue to do that with relationships with all of the tools on Tool Finder. And I use Superhuman probably 2 hours a day, and there's no quicker emails out there. Obviously it's a much more pricier, but I am lucky to be working for myself, so I can correlate the output of my work to the cost of it in general. So that's something that you should be aware of, and that's what I always typically recommend with email apps, is look at the correlation between output and production, whether you're freelance or self-employed. So next up, I use Notion. Now, Notion isn't really a big application in my daily routine. It's probably open once a day, and I tend to use it for documents, bringing ideas together that I can share with team members and collaborate on them. Now, to be honest, it's not really something I use for the databases. It's not something I use to plan my calendar or anything like that. I just really use it to dump everything in one location and build it out with comments and also just general text formatting. To be honest, I probably could use any app for this, but I find a good home on Notion for that. I also use it as things like payouts and finances to keep track of team finances and making sure that expenses are reduced as well. And finally, note-taking applications. I don't really use a note-taking application, but more recently, I've been moving back to Evernote as a way to do my journal. Probably last 3 or 4 months, since Evernote stabilized realized I've actually been using it as a way to do a weekly journal and to reflect on the week that has been. Now, I don't typically take notes, but if I'm saving something like my council tax bill, I'll put it in Evernote, and then I've got it as a digital version that I can share with other people. And also, it's just a handy way for me to store stuff in more of a personal context than a work context. So I still use it, and it's got all that storage of my previous 10 years of Evernote history in it, which is very helpful. Now, as you can see, I only use 5 applications here, one that I might even be dropping if Todoist introduced a Google Calendar integration. So you can see that somebody who is talking about lots of productivity applications doesn't necessarily need to use a lot of productivity applications. Sometimes I think the core of productivity is actually about how you use a tool and keeping tools minimal. I've been really guilty in the past of having loads of productivity tools and using them, maybe even 10 to 15 at one given time. And sometimes distilling your workflows and your processes is actually something you need to do to be more productive than actually to add more tools to the situation. Yes, there are probably smaller tools that I use in my daily routine to get more stuff done, like ChatGPT, Remarkable, and other tools like that. But largely, those are my 5 core tools. And as you can see, they are pretty much lightly used in a sense, because I believe in output more so than the micromanagement of your productivity. And I think the future tools will reflect that. So they're my productivity tools. Let us know what yours are in the comments below. I'd love to see the combination of apps that you use, so feel free to share it. If you're new here to the channel, I would love to see you more, so do subscribe. And if you're in the hunt for any productivity tools or want to know more about these tools, you can find them linked below. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all in a future video. Cheerio for now. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Tool Finder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing. And naturally, there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.